So, an Instagram post about me, eh?
What the fuck? What are you doing here and why are you following me to my car?
Ha 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 ha, did I scare you? How pathetic. Perhaps it's the same reason why you stole my photo and used it to make a degrading social media post about me to the public?
I didn't steal anything. Your photo was on the public website for our school. I just used it so that people are able to identify the evil and wicked person I'm talking about. And you know exactly what you're talking about because you've been tormenting me for ages now. Even threatening to run me off the campus all because I defended myself against your friend.
Still took a photo that wasn't yours to use in an Instagram post dedicated to me. You must really be that obsessed, huh? And since when is calling my friend name after name and verbally attacking him, defending yourself? The only thing he asked you to do was get lost, sweetie. It's not our fault that you're too much of a snowflake to handle constructive criticism. Your idea of defending yourself is bullying others. I won't let that slide easily. Now you saw that the dean didn't believe you nor give a fuck, and nor did Lydia or anyone else. Even people outside of her friend group are agreeing that what you did was not only petty but very childish. Soon enough, everyone will be against you, and you'll have no purpose left staying here at this campus. Just give it up already, Carson, you're not going to win this battle.
Oh, I'm the obsessed one, right? Yet you're the one who has been relentlessly bullying and harassing me for weeks. You're the one who's been following me around everywhere I go. And you're the one who's desperately trying to get me to leave campus. The more threats you make, Brian, the harder I'm gonna fight. I'm not gonna kowtow to you and let you intimidate me. Not only that, but the more threats you make, the worse it's gonna get for you. I won't just tell my friends and the dean everything you're saying, but I'll tell everyone I know. Even if the dean doesn't listen to me, and even if Lydia and her bomb-ass friends don't listen to me, someone will. So good luck in your quest of trying to get me to leave, but the more you try, the more chaotic I will make sure everything will get. I won't give up.
You can try that, honey, but I promise you, it won't get you anywhere. It won't look so good for you when all students and all staff on campus see you as nothing more than a drama starter who instigates trouble everywhere she goes. I'll tell you this now, you're lucky the dean made you take down that post. Because if you didn't, I would have made things so much worse on you than I am right now, you assless twig. And I'll continue to call you what you are, trans fag. Yes, I'm calling you a trans fag because you have no curves in sight, because no real woman is built like you.
Always with the insults on my body, constantly trying to hurt me because you feel slighted. You say I'm childish and petty, yet you can't seem to resist bringing my body and my weight into every argument, even though it has nothing to do with the argument at hand.
Cry more about it, freak. I'm just here to remind you exactly what you are, a freak of nature that nobody wants in sight. You're the worst out of all of your freak friends, Zephyr, Abby, Penelope, as big of freaks they are, they pale in comparison to you. That explains why your only defense mechanism is making a silly post about me online. Watch your back, Carson. I'll be seeing you in 2 weeks.
Go fuck yourself, you childish and pompous asshole.
Carson, are you okay?
Yeah, just had a rough day at school today is all. Homework and workload and such.
Are you sure? It looks like it might be more than just that.
I'm sure.
Come sit down with me, I can tell something isn't right. Now tell me, what else is happening?
Alright, fine. I've been getting bullied on campus by this guy named Brian, and on the occasional basis some of his friends. Because of a party I went to one night where one of his friends was blatantly insulting us and harassing us, and I stood up against him. The guy's name was Tyler. Brian saw me telling Tyler to back off basically, and he saw it as me bullying his friend. Then he himself joined in on the bullying and said my friends and I deserved it anyways because we're annoying. Ever since then, Brian has made it his mission to make my life miserable on campus. He told me that if I told anyone, no one would believe me, and he made multiple threats to chase me off campus so I would never come back. Then he destroyed my essay for my English class and admitted it straight to my face. Despite the fact that I told the dean and my professor about it, they said they couldn't do anything because there was no proof that Brian did any of it. So I dealt with it the only way I thought possible, and I made a post on Instagram and made it publicly about Brian, detailing the kind of stuff he does and the kind of person he is. My so-called friend Lydia saw it, and even though she promised me she'd talk to Brian about his nasty behavior, apparently he sold her on a bunch of lies, and she believed him over me. So she turned against me and threw away our friendship because I made the post. Then her and her friends told the dean about it. The dean was upset and told me that if I didn't take down the post, he'd expel me from campus. He also said he could legally sue me over it because I included the college's name in my post. Now I just have a 2-week suspension as a punishment for even making the post, but since I was forced to take it down, I'm still allowed back there. Brian is still tormenting me and threatening me, and at this point I'm lost on what to do.
Well, number one, whoever this Brian kid is, we need to get him in check fast. I wish you would have told me this stuff sooner, so I could have helped you out. Making an Instagram post about him is just gonna make you look like the problematic one. That's most likely why it didn't work out in your favor. If you would have told me from the get-go, I would have set up an appointment with your dean and professor, and I would have told them to personally make sure that Brian kid stays far, far away from you and does not talk to you at all, or else they'd have to face me and your father. At this point, I believe you've just pissed everyone off, including Brian, and that's why things are taking a downward spiral. I'll have a talk with your dean and professor about this guy, because all of this is completely and utterly unacceptable behavior for a college student. Did your professor not let you turn in a new copy of your essay?
No, she didn't. She told me that the rules are the rules, and if she made an exception for me, she'd have to make an exception for everyone in the class.
Unbelievable. You worked for weeks on that essay, all for it to go to waste because of a circumstance that was out of your control. These people need to do better. If Brian did something to your essay, they should have cameras that were able to capture what he was doing the time it happened.
I know. Believe me, I'm just as angry about it as you are. But they were unable to find any evidence of him tampering with my stuff.
I'll be going up there tomorrow to have a word with that dean of yours. Something has to be done about this, because this is not okay.
I just hope he listens to you, because he never listened to me.
Oh, he will. I'll make sure of it. There will be heavy consequences for your school if they don't get their act together.
And not only Brian, but his friends keep calling me trans and a quote-unquote faggot because they think I'm a man. Why, you might ask? Just because I'm skinny and have no curves. I'm tired of always getting picked on for my body. I just wish I could gain some weight. Maybe then people wouldn't constantly bring up my weight and body shape in every argument I get into.
Sweetie, they're just trying to get under your skin. I wouldn't listen to anything any of those assholes have to say. I was also skinny like you when I was your age, so you got it honestly.
Yeah, I know. But I've been picked on for it nearly my entire life. I'm so tired of it. I'm a grown adult now, yet I still feel like I have the body of a much younger girl, or guy as people like to say now.
You do not have the body of a guy. Just because you're skinny, or petite as I would like to say, doesn't mean you look like a guy. These people at your school are just nasty and miserable people who are trying to bring you down because they don't feel good about their own selves. I would take anything any of them have to say, and just chuck it out the window, Carson.
I'm trying, but it's hard to when it's all I ever hear from people nowadays.
Don't worry, none of this will be going on for too much longer.
All of this constant bullying and insults coming from so many people's ends started making me develop more intense body image issues than before. I never grew up liking my body, but constantly being called names and slurs because of my natural appearance started making me hate myself. I was obsessing over how I looked in the mirror, checking the scale to make sure I'm staying above a certain weight, and comparing myself to women with curvy hourglass figures online. I look so disgusting. Why can't I just gain weight already? Eating a lot never helps. I don't know what else to do. My cursed fast metabolism made it to where even if I did try and eat more, I either gained no weight at all, or very little weight. People always tried to invalidate me when I felt bad about that, saying it's better than not being able to lose. Well, I think both are equally as bad. I want to have some control over my weight. My BMI is 16. I'm literally so underweight for my height. No wonder I look so terrible. I really do need to gain weight. Everyone is right about me. My mother gave me the good news, at least, that when she threatened to take my situation going on with Brian to the police and even to the news, the dean promised he would put a requirement in place that Brian has to stay at least 10 feet away from me when we're not in class together, and he is not allowed to talk to me under any circumstance during class. But I still had a week and a half to kill of not being in school thanks to that jackass. The entire time I was obsessing over my appearance and weight, and it was hell. I would cry or have full-blown mental breakdowns if I dropped any weight I gained, or if I already dropped more than I already weigh. I didn't tell anyone about this for a while, I was hoping I would be able to get it under control on my own, but I wasn't. Hey guys, I'm back.
Welcome
oh, you're
back.
Finally back. Welcome back.
Welcome back.
Thanks guys. I do have some good news. My mom dealt with the school, and now Brian is not allowed within 10 feet of me outside of class. He also is not allowed to speak to me at all.
Good. It's about damn time something is being done about that prick.
For real. I can't believe what he did to you, Carson.
Me neither. The worst part is that Lydia and her friends think I'm lying about it. They think I'm the instigator, as Brian wants everyone to believe. Lydia even went as far as insulting me and saying that she's glad we aren't friends anymore.
Yeah, I heard about that. I'm disappointed with the way Lydia handled this, to be honest. I expected better of her, but no, she believed an asshole over her own friends.
Right? I'm glad some people still have sense in this situation. Brian told me that everyone else thinks I'm the one at fault here, and they all think I'm childish for making that post.
Yeah, Lydia and Brian do have a fair number of people turned against you. I'm not gonna argue that one. But not everyone thinks badly of you. Most people are just neutral and don't want to get involved in the drama.
Who all is against me then?
Well, Lydia and her friends are some. That includes Chelsea, Reagan, Kayla, Justin, and Jared. Then the obvious, which is Brian, Kim, and Tyler.
Kayla? Why Kayla? I thought her and I were on somewhat good terms, even if we hardly talk. And why the hell is my toxic ex Justin and his toxic best friend Jared even involved in any of this?
That I don't know. Kayla, Justin, and Jared were all of the opinion that you could have handled this better, and that making that post was problematic and childish.
Well, Justin and Jared should shut the fuck up then, because the shit that the both of them have done to me before is far worse than any quote-unquote childish post out there. I did what I had to do to draw attention to the fact that my personal safety was at risk. So all of them can gladly shut the fuck up. Actually, I'll talk to them myself sometime today.
Good luck, just don't go in guns blazing, or more drama will probably arise.
I won't, but I'm pissed that two of the most toxic fuckers I know actually have an opinion on this. Brian has not only caused my friends and I a ton of grief, but he is the reason my grade has dropped in my English class thanks to his vandalism. He has dug his way out of taking responsibility for the fact he got me suspended for 2 weeks, is spreading lies to people and turning my friends against me, and with all of his constant body shaming alongside the others, my body image issues have gotten worse. I fucking hate him. He can burn in hell for all I care.
That I agree with. He's been mean to me a few times before, so I definitely believe you and I'll defend you against him.
Thank you. It means a lot.
No problem. Anytime. Come on, let's get going. Class is starting for us in a few minutes.